Welcome back, Vinyl Community. What we're going to try to do here today is a video that I've been trying to get done for some time now. I've done maybe 10 or 15 different takes of this over the past couple years, and just haven't gotten around to doing a solid video. I keep getting more and want to start over. Anyway, I'm going to be showing my Beatles vinyl collection, and I recently just got all new clear plastic sleeves for these, which some of them were 10, 15 years old now, so they weren't in the best shape, the sleeves, that is, plastic sleeves. So we're just going to go ahead and start right out. I'm going to start out with Savage Young Beatles. This is a 2010 release. I picked this up when I was in Florence, Italy, a couple weeks ago. This is a European pressing. I'm not sure of its exact origin, but it is unofficial. But it also came with a CD copy of this album, so I didn't pay very much for it. Alright, songs, pictures, and stories of the Fabulous Beatles. This is one of the more expensive Beatle albums that's, or as in it tends to sell for far more than your average one. It is introducing the Beatles as the album that it comes with. When VJ were being taken to court over the release of Introducing the Beatles, they were trying to repackage the recordings that they did have. Here's the album in question, Introducing the Beatles. This one isn't in very good shape at all. I had a better copy years ago, probably going on 10 years ago now. And this label. It was a far better copy, better condition, but I don't know what year it was from. It was a bootleg, it was a counterfeit, whatever you'd like to call it. And I was trying to impress a girl, so you know, 12, 13 on me was trying to impress a girl who was another year or so older than me that liked the Beatles, and I gave her that bootleg copy. Didn't work out with that girl. Meet the Beatles, it's the next one. There's some ring wear on it. Label there. A lot of these aren't in the best condition. Several of these I bought some 10 years ago when I first started finding Beatles albums. So I would buy them whenever I saw them. And I've seen better copies of this, it's just I haven't had the need to go out and pay the money for them. Most of these I paid almost nothing for, which some of these conditions you can understand. Beatles' second album. I'm gonna fly through a lot of these here. If they have a standard Capitol label, I'll just pass them by. It's a Hard Day's Night on United Artists. Some of the records themselves might not look that great, but I don't have any, none of these albums skip or have any problems. This is actually an upgrade that I got of something new. This is very clean, this is a very white back. I don't think that this was some sort of a repressing. I think this is an original copy. It's in stereo. Feel free to let me know in the comments below. If you find out anything about any of these records that I didn't mention. Some of these records have people's names on them from way back when, so if you happen to know these people from anywhere in the Mid-Ohio Valley or Pittsburgh area, Beatles 65. There's a stereo copy. Beatles Story. I've seen copies of this, but I just never been one that I really thought I needed to get. And the only reason I have this one is because I got it for a really good deal on eBay. And they took the picture of the record like this on the listing, claiming it was the original. I got it. It's an Apple pressing from the early 70s, I believe, 71. This is the help. This is a really, really bad condition. I opted out and had an Apple press into this and gave it away. Despite the cover of the record, like I said, the records do play. They play fine. Some of them have a few cracks and pops here, but nothing, you can't hardly tell on any of these. The early Beatles. It's a stereo copy. This belonged to someone in Parkersburg, West Virginia at one point in time. I got this one. My brother had this one for many years ago. He gave it to me, which I needed it because I had the mono copy. Save that one. Alright, Beatles 6. I picked up this copy and switched out. I had an Apple copy. I switched out and got that one. Here we have Rubber Soul. This is the first copy of Rubber Soul that I ever got. This one's in mono. It's my favorite album. It's got some ring wear, but I recently picked up a stereo copy on eBay, which has better condition on the album cover. Save that one there. The next few we're gonna get into here. Go ahead and start here. This was my first copy of Yesterday and Today. As you can see, not in very good shape. The record is fine. This isn't paste over. This is Third State, I think they call it. I don't remember which is which. This is the all new cover. It's not a paste over. This is just what's there. Yeah, that one's in mono. This is a much cleaner copy that I picked up not too long ago in stereo. And so we'll move on to this one here. This is one I just recently picked up. This is a boot. I guess you would call it it would be a bootleg. It's counterfeit. I'm not sure where from. The person I bought it from shipped it from the UK. Discogs listed as a US release from 2010. It's on green, translucent, almost like a marbled vinyl. I guess I can show you the label there. The label has no mention of stereo. The cover itself lists it as stereo. It's a very difficult one to get back in the sleeve. Yeah, this lists it as stereo. The album itself is in a fake stereo. It's mono, but the left channel is normal and the right channel is just the exact same as the left, except for they enhance the bass on it, so it's just an all over more of a bass sound. But it's a fine quality. It's fine when I don't want to play the original and worry about any wearing it out or any sort of anything like that, which I know you can't really wear them out unless you have a shitty needle, but I'd rather listen to that one. While on the subject, there's one or two people on eBay selling these. These are just reproduction slicks of the original cover. And this cover's actually in better quality pressing than this one. But, alright, we're gonna stop there because the last time that I tried this, I went on for 40 minutes with the rest of them. So we're gonna call this part one and we're gonna move on to part two. So, see you later, final community.